R22 Tout Monde, antenne cadiste.
Literature must become an integral part of the community's lifestyle.
Black literature must become an integral part of the community's lifestyle.
Black literature must become an integral part of the community's lifestyle.
Mm-hmm. Black literature must become an integral part of the community's lifestyle.
Black literature must become an integral part of the community's lifestyle. I believe that end must also be integral to the myths and experience underlying the total history of black people.
And I believe that it must also be integral to the myths and experiences underlying the total history of black people.
And I believe that it must also be integral to the myths and experiences underlying the total history of black people.
Sing it.
People.
All right, now.
People.
And I believe.
Don't do that.
That it must also be integral to the myth and experiences underlying the total history.
And I believe that it must also be integral to the myth's experience underlying the total history of black people.
Because
if I'm swept out
with a broom,
it will humiliate me.
And I will lose my self-respect
if we must die.
Not found. Bring some more people out here to shake your hands, right? How's everybody? Everybody all right? Y'all all right out there? Good, good. We're showing up the truth. We are glad to be here and glad to see you and everything. Like, British Airways got me here. Scared the shit out of me. My hair looked like Don King. That's why. They said, we are having a little problem with the landing gear. I said, well, fuck it. Don't land then. No, no, don't do nothing wrong. We've been going around trying to tell people, recruiting is what we're doing. Yeah. I don't like nobody messing with Max, man. We have been trying to recruit people because we need some more volunteers for bluesology. And in order to get people into bluesology, folks have been saying, well, tell me a little bit about it, and maybe I can join up. So we have come out to tell you a little bit about bluesology. First of all, if you can't get no job, put an ology on the end of the shit you like to do and open up an office, and people will come and consult you on that shit, you see. This is how bluesology started. Couldn't get no job. I had the blues. I said, shit, that's a job. But we have developed it into a science. And they give us some projects to do. And you may be able to help me with this one. The question was, why are there no black people in monster movies? You see, bluesology is the science of how things feel. So they asked me to find out how black people felt about not being, because we like horror movies. We go to all of them, but we're not in them. So I went to speak to a well-known producer of horror movies, and I came at him straight up. I said, look here, man, what's happening? How come we can pay to be in the monster movie and see it, but ain't never none of us on the screen? He said, well, Gil, what we have is a credibility problem. I said, oh, shit, he ain't gonna tell me. I said, what does that mean? He said, everybody knows monsters cannot catch black people. I understand what he means. You see, you go to a horror movie, you see a bunch of people, and you try to figure out who's gonna live. Well, if it's a monster movie, we gonna live. The motherfucking monster go doo 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 doo. Ain't gonna catch no brother. On 14th Street in the neighborhood, you can whisper the word junkie. They won't say nothing. But if you whisper the word monster, a junkie will turn into Jesse Owens. The only problem with this is that white people can't run. Because as soon as they see the monster, they go, oh, shit. And they fall the fuck down. And we'd be emotional about that shit. We'd be saying, get up, motherfucker, get up. Tell somebody, get up. They'd be laying there. Doo-doo. Doo-doo. Brother could have got up, gone get something to eat, laid, come back. Doo-doo. So I said, well, look here, man. All the monsters ain't slow. So why don't you put us in a movie where the monster is quick? He said, well, you know, Gil, what we were going to do was put a black person in the movie Jaws. I said, oh, shit, that would have been wild. Why didn't it work? He said, well, let me show you on the screen here. Pulled out a screen. I saw him. He had on his little director's hat and shit. He turned around. He said, Willie, that was the brother. He said, Willie, I want you to climb down here along this side here. I want you to scoot over here, and then I want you to jump in the water. Willie said, run that back. Willie said, I heard the first part. You said, slide down here, and then go over here, and then do what? Jump in the water. The water over here? Jaws is in the motherfucking water. Why would I do that shit? Jaws is in the water. Didn't you see that motherfucker? So the director had a problem. He had a credibility problem. Because once black people know Jaws is in the water, the movie's over. We're not going in the motherfucking water for no reason. So he said, then I had a clever idea. I decided to make a black person the first victim. This would be before you knew that Jaws was in the water. I said, well, shit, that ought to work. What happened? He said, black people can hear the music. But they do, do, do. They must know Jaws is in the motherfucking water. Get out the water. So here come that shark with his band. You see, movies are all about whose side you're on, who you want to win. When I went to see the movie Jaws, I was on Jaws' side. Yeah, I was rooting for Jaws. Because as a black man, I can understand being fucked with when you're where you're supposed to be. Jaws was in the water. Where the fuck you want him? You see, if Jaws pull up on shore, rent a car, come over to your house and fuck with you, we got a problem. But Jaws was in the water. They rented a boat and went out there to fuck with Jaws. I said, eat them some bitches, no problem. You got to root for the thing that's in the right. And in order to get people into bluesology,
and in order to get people into bluesology, Season.